IVM.
Did you know that the no sugar added means that refined sugar has not been added by the manufacturer? But there are many other substitutes that might be added. The whole truth, first and only clean label brand in India, never uses such substitutes. Everything they provide, such as protein bars, vegan energy bars, immunity balls, was grown on a farm and never in a lab. The whole truth declares each and every ingredient on the front of the pack. Check out thewholetruthfoods.com and enter the coupon code HABIT for an awesome 20% discount on checkout. Make eating healthy a new part of your daily habit. Hello and welcome to the Habit Coach podcast, the bite-sized podcast filled with quick and easy actionable habits. Remember, great habits create that awesome life. I am Ashton Doctor, your Habit Coach. And today's fun fact of the day has to do with tongues. Did you know that there is something called the Gorlin sign? This is a medical term for the ability to touch your nose with your tongue. What is interesting is that only 10% of the population has this ability. At this point in time, you might want to try it out for yourself if you've never done this before. Creep your tongue over your top lip and try touching your nose. See if you can. Let me know. I can do this, and it's been a fun conversation piece for years, asking if someone else can do it. Do they have the ability to or not? As this is believed to be a genetic trait, either you have it or you don't. Now compare this with the ability of rolling your tongue. You will see a big difference. The rolling your tongue ability became popular a few years ago because of an email that kept getting forwarded all over and mentions in various movies. But it is very common. About 65% of the population has the ability to be able to turn their tongue into a roll. So it's not really a rare thing. Again, it is linked to your genes. Either you have the ability to do it or not. Whereas being able to move or wriggle your ears is something that we can all learn to do. It is something that we have to work towards and train ourselves for. We are born with the muscles to be able to wriggle our ears. Yet, only 10% of the population actually can. I had to teach myself how to do it. It took a while to get my mind-muscle connection and then make the muscle strong enough to wriggle the ears. But it is possible. It is not impossible. In our lives, we often mistake what we cannot do as impossible. We think of it as abilities you're born with or abilities you're born without. Like licking your nose. One such mistake we make is with discipline. We feel that we were not born with the ability to be disciplined. I get so many people who write in to me saying that they can't do these things, they can't make the changes because they don't have self-discipline or that they aren't disciplined. And to a large extent, this idea is put into us at an early age. We see the toppers in our school sitting diligently, taking notes, writing down everything so seriously. We see them studying on time, working hard. And that's when we hear it from our parents. Ashton, you're not disciplined. Our teachers in school tell us and separate us into disciplined and those who aren't. We hear them say that we can never be like the others. And this stays with us for our life, like a tattoo on our minds. We were probably hurt when we heard it for the first time, but then we realize that it's a great excuse to get out of things that you don't want to do. We start using it as an excuse. However, very soon it becomes who you think you are. Hence, anything that feels hard, you avoid doing and blame it on your inability to be disciplined. You say, I don't have self-discipline. As your habit coach, this makes my blood boil. The very reason I created this whole world of habit coaching is so that you never have to rely on discipline again. So that you can, once and for all, burn that tattoo of not being self-disciplined. And this is because only once you can do this, can you actually make change and get healthier, get richer, get more peaceful, get happier. Discipline is nothing more than consistency. If you follow the golden rules of habit change, consistency is easy. In fact, the entire third rule of habit change is all about consistency. Never miss 2 days in a row. That's the rule. Never miss 2 days in a row. Consistency is not about doing something every single day like a robot. Consistency is about doing something more than just 50% of the time. Hence, the never miss 2 days in a row is a rule. You will end up missing a day here and a day there. Life happens. You might have to go for a wedding. You might have a doctor's appointment, or you might not be feeling well, and that's okay. But as a rule, as a principle, the next day, no matter what happens, do that habit. You will notice that this small tweak will give you all the discipline you thought you lacked. So make a promise to me today. Please make a promise that you will never think of yourself as lacking self-discipline. Instead, try the never miss 2 days in a row rule. You can learn about these three rules on my YouTube channel if you haven't already seen it. It's called Awesome 180. Discipline is not like the ability to touch your nose with your tongue. It is not a genetic trait. Discipline is like the ability to wriggle your ears. Something that you can learn if only you knew how. Just remember, never miss 2 days in a row. So start these habits and share with us your progress using the hashtag TheHabitCoach. If you like this podcast, don't forget to check out other interesting podcasts on the IVM network. You can listen to us on the IVM Podcast app or ivmpodcast.com. You can also follow us on social media. We are at IVM Podcasts on Twitter and Instagram. If you want to reach out to me, I am Ashden Doc on Twitter and Instagram. You can find lots more information on my website, awesome180.com, or check out different content on my YouTube channel called AWESOME180. That's Awesome180.
I hope you enjoyed that show. If you aren't following us on social media, please do. We're IVM Podcasts on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. Let me quickly thank our sponsors on the network this week. Storytel, thewholetruthfoods.com, and we have a new sponsor in SEAD. Thank you all so much for being part of the network. So, this is Valentine's week, and we have a bunch of stuff for you guys. So I'm going to give you a couple of episodes that you could definitely catch up with. Ugla Station, Season 2, Episode 12, Be Our Valentine. Ritasha and Ayushi have a little bit of talk about love and all the rest of the stuff that goes wrong with that. On The Habit Coach, Episode 396, Ash and Doctor did an episode which went into the much-debated origins of Valentine's Day. Also, do check out Candid Kannan with Siddharth Kannan featuring Govinda and his wife, Sunita Ahuja. He talks to them about amazing 33 years together. But you know what, folks? If you want to hear more about these Valentine's Day things, what I suggest is go to our webpage, ivmpodcast.com/blog. And on the blog, we're going to post a bunch of different playlists that we've created for all the various major services. So if you're feeling in the mood for love, do check that out. You'll definitely enjoy it. Just a quick note on a few other noteworthy episodes this week. Nankari Kunal Vijaykar was the guest. They spoke about street food with him. On Simplified, they talk about vaccinating a billion people, then the logistical and administrative task in front of us. And on The Wire Talks, Siddharth talks to Devdutt Mukhopadhyay about the human cost of internet shutdowns. And with that, I hope to see you again next week.
Want to learn something new and have a few minutes to spare? Well, then go for The Traveling Professor's Diary, where I, Siddharth Deshmukh, the traveling professor, will help you glean from all the insights that I've gained from wherever I've traveled, learned, taught, and repeated. Join me every Tuesday and Thursday on the IVM Podcast website, app, or wherever you get your podcasts from.